Hello and welcome to What Is It Wednesday? Today's question covers 4th edition task list item B07 or 5th edition task list item D05. And today's question is, which of the main experimental designs tests one independent variable across two or more dependent variables? And the answer is multiple baseline design. Let's talk about the multiple baseline design. This is the design that typically looks like three rows of line graphs that are staggered like steps, displaying the independent variable being implemented in that staggered fashion across either two or more behaviors, two or more settings, or two or more subjects. And that's the two or more dependent variables that we're talking about. I know typically dependent variable means a behavior and the thing that's being measured as the independent variables are being implemented, but this design is unique in that we have only one independent variable, and that independent variable is being implemented across two or more behaviors, a dependent variable, or two or more settings. Again, that's a variation of a dependent variable, or two or more subjects. Again, in this case, kind of like a dependent variable. And then what happens, or what is shown, is the generalization of the effects of this independent variable across these dependent variables. The multiple baseline design is the most utilized experimental design because of this sort of flexibility that it has, and it's easy to do. It's easy to look at the impact of an independent variable, especially when you don't have to withdraw the independent variable. So because you don't have to withdraw an independent variable, this is the design that should be used when you're dealing with target behaviors that are irreversible, or when it's not appropriate or possible to remove the effective independent variable, or when you're trying to show the generalization effects of an independent variable. Now, there are three subtypes of this design: multiple baseline across behaviors, multiple baseline across subjects, and multiple baseline across settings. And by the way, across subjects, that's the most popular or the most utilized in ABA. There are also a couple of weaker variations: the multiple probe design and the delayed multiple baseline design. And also one more, the non-concurrent multiple baseline design. And these options should be used when the extended baseline measurement is either unnecessary, or it's impractical, or it's too costly or unavailable, or for some other reason that prevents you from using just the straightforward multiple baseline design. I hope that helps, and I'll see you guys next time.